Hey everybody, I'm Stormsteel, and for you dual universe entrepreneurs out there, I'd like to give you a few different ways to use your dispensers to get more efficiency and convenience for both you and your customers. Before we get started, just a friendly reminder that I stream Dual Universe on Twitch several times a week. Link to that is in the description below. Check the About section on my Twitch channel to see my current streaming schedule. If you have any questions about Dual Universe, need any help, or just want someone to hang out with while we play, feel free to head on over to my Twitch. So as usual, I'm here at the Stormsteel Industries build hangar and showroom, where we'll be talking about dispensers today. Just a quick note, if you're watching this video, I am assuming that you know the ins and outs of fundamentals of dispensers, all of their settings, how to set up RDMS to make them usable to certain groups of people, just the basic functionings of it. So if you don't know that already, make sure to check out my DU for Dummies video on dispensers. There'll be a link to that in the description. So assuming you're already comfortable and knowledgeable on just how to place a dispenser and how to make those settings work, let's get into it. So I've got three different sort of ways that I notice most people use dispensers, and I want to make sure that you're aware of all of them so you know all your options on how you want to sell your products. So first off, let's talk about probably the simplest, which is just placing a dispenser on a static core here. So a lot of shops will have this, a lot of showrooms will have this, where they'll just grab a dispenser, place it on the floor of their static core, and then link that to a container nearby, either that has blueprints for a ship or a particular item that that person produces from industry. So this is kind of how Gotchar has Gotmart set up, is a bunch of dispensers placed on their static cores with containers linked so that you can buy directly from his industry production. This is also probably the best way to go if you want to sell ship tokens. So if you're planning on through a dispenser, right? So people can come to me and I will put together a ship token for them, but a lot of people don't want to coordinate that, or it's difficult to coordinate between time zones. So certain ship builders will have dispensers where you can, with one batch, with one use of the dispenser, you can purchase the whole token and it will put all of the items necessary to build that ship into your linked container. Now for you as the seller, this means that this dispenser is going to have to be linked to a container hub with several containers on it. If you're just selling like pocketable ships, ship tokens from these dispensers, that's not too tough. A single large container is probably plenty to have 20, 30 tokens worth of that pocketable ship in that container. With the pocketable ship, you can also be using the deprecated dispenser, which has 20 kiloliters of volume in the batch content. If you're selling tokens for larger extra small ships or small core, or even medium core, you're going to need to use the regular dispenser. It just says dispenser. It doesn't say deprecated or anything. It doesn't have any other words on it. It just says dispenser. And that has a much larger batch volume that you can use. And of course, you'll need to be linked to a much larger set of containers linked to a hub. Getting into medium core, you'll probably even need to think about using extra large containers. That is, of course, if you're wanting to store multiple tokens worth. If you only want to store one or two tokens worth of that medium core ship in the containers at a time, then a series of large containers will probably do fine. But if you want to have a good stock going, you're going to need bigger and more containers, obviously. So this is probably the simplest way to use a dispenser, placing on a static core, linking it directly to a large base of containers, a large container hub, or just, you know, however many containers you need to sell that particular product. So this method is obviously great when you're selling large products, ship tokens, or just for your own showroom, your own shop, somewhere that is static, that is not going to be moving, that you have complete autonomy. Now, we've talked about placing dispensers on a static core for your own static shop or location, but obviously you can't just stay to yourself. Sometimes you have to go to the customer, or sometimes there's special events. So you also need ways to bring dispensers and your stock to other places. Usually this involves voxel art or ships. So usually you're not stocking, you know, industry and products, individual products, when you go to events or to bring your sale to another place. So usually at this point, it's just a blueprint and maybe some honeycomb if you're planning to sell some voxel art tokens. It's pretty tough to sell ship tokens mobile but you could do it with a big enough hauling ship. You could make that happen. So we're going to talk about that now. You can, of course, place a dispenser on a dynamic core. So I've got my ship here, and using arrow keys, I can just move the dispenser around. And if I were, you know, placing this ship at an expo or some sort of event, I would just line it up with the ground here and I'd place it. And there you go. Now you have what looks like a dispenser on the ground, but it's actually part of that dynamic core, which means that I can now link this dispenser to the container hub inside my ship. And now I can use the ship's hold so you have to go from the container to the dispenser. So there's a good note. Oh no, it's working already. And so now I can use the ship's hold as the storage for whatever this dispenser is, and it's become quite mobile. If you have like a medium or large core hauler, then you might have enough volume and mass carriage to actually bring a few tokens with you as well. But personally, that's a lot of organization, a lot of effort for me. So I just do this kind of thing to bring blueprints around. When you do something like this, you're probably also going to want to bring a screen of some kind to put over the dispenser, at least to give some info about the ship or ways to contact you if they do want a token. To take this idea a little further even, I'm actually planning on using this carrier, since this is for my my big mini game that's up and coming in DU called Battle Beasts, where you actually build extra small ships and sort of go into a simulated combat using some Lua. This is a carrier for those. And so I'm actually gonna plan to fly this around with some dispensers in the loading bay with a screen with some info, and actually carry around some of the battle beasts I'm gonna build to sell. And then you can buy blueprints or maybe even tokens right here from the carrier. So that's kind of how I'm gonna use, even though there's an extra small core ship docked right here, that's gonna end up being the show model on the carrier. And then you could buy your blueprint or token right there. So if you're a racer, or you're gonna get into battle beasts, or you know, you just have small ships that you carry around on a nice presentable carrier like this, you could throw down your dispensers next to where you park the ship on your carrier. And that's a great way to go about selling things. Now, last but certainly not least, sort of the main method that I use for dispensers personally is actually having dispensers and a nice extra small container on their own little extra small dynamic core. So you see, I can maneuver this around because it's on a dynamic core. So what I actually have done is I've designed this nice little voxel casing for my dispensers, which no matter where you put a dispenser, I highly recommend using, you know, just real basic voxel work to just try and create a nice little facade to your dispensers. It just gives a nice look, helps you kind of have a better brand image. There's a lot of really appealing things about putting some nice decoration over your dispensers, regardless of where or how you're placing them. In my case, though, I went ahead and built this little voxel work around a dispenser and a small container, an extra small container and an extra small core, because all I really sell are blueprints. I don't really sell my ship tokens out of dispensers. I handle that personally. So when that's the case, when you're just selling blueprints, you can really get away with just an extra small container on an extra small dynamic core. And these are really great because once you make one, you can blueprint it. So for example, I have a container hub in my build hangar that I'm linked to right now, that I keep all the stuff to build these, I call them my kiosks, and I can just take that blueprint, slap it down under Stormsteel Industries, name it whatever I want, so Stormsteel Show Kiosk, right? And deploy that, and then there you have it. Now, the one thing to note about that is I do use lights to create some cool effect on my kiosk. Lights do not save their settings between blueprints through blueprinting. So if you use lights with any blueprint, you're going to want to make sure that you have to go through and do those settings again, replace those settings. But the screens will keep their info. So if you have like a screen like that you use for advertising or for giving information on products, you'll still have that sort of baseline framework that you can just go in and edit later. So you see all my screens are pretty similar. I use the same framework for all of them. So even though it's not the same info that I might want, it's really easy for me to change. Now, this is cool for a lot of reasons. You can just take the supplies with you and deploy these wherever you want. If you know you're going to be moving stuff around in your showroom a lot and you decide to do dispensers this way, then it's really easy to move the dispenser as well. You don't have to do any copy pasting or elements moving or anything like that. You can just maneuver tool this over there or dock it onto a ship and maneuver that ship over, which is another great thing. If you're taking a ship to a showroom, you can build this at home. If you don't want to bother sorting the materials, you can just build this at home, dock it to whatever ship you're taking over to a fly-in or a ship show or someone else's showroom, and just fly it over. It's just a dispenser with blueprints in it, so it's going to be super lightweight no matter what. As long as it's a small core ship or bigger, it's not going to hinder you at all to just bring this with you. The last thing that I really like about doing dispensers this way is that when someone purchases something from your dispenser, it actually shows in your wallet. If I go to the Stormsteel Industries wallet, right, you can see stuff like player Ada Bug spent 10 million quanta on our bizarre kiosk Banshee. And so that tells me exactly which construct they spent that money from. So that's really helpful to know which of your products are selling. If you place them on a static core, it will just tell you the name of the construct of the core, like where they bought it, right? So if you've got a whole shop of ships right here, like if I had my dispensers on the SSI showroom 1A, right, then it would just tell me that something was bought from that core and I wouldn't know exactly what. It would narrow it down, but I still wouldn't know exactly what. If you decide to do dispensers this way on these dynamic cores, you can name them whatever you want to be very specific. For example, this is the Stormsteel kiosk Nimbus. So if somebody buys from this, I know that somebody bought a Nimbus. And that's going to help me keep organized, know when I need to refill my blueprints, know which of my ships are selling and which ones really aren't selling. So there's really a lot of advantages to doing this. Maybe just a little bit more work in terms of the materials you need and the organization, but in my opinion, it's worth it. All right, guys, that's it for dispensers. As always, I hope this was helpful. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below the video. If you have any questions or any ways that you use dispensers that maybe I didn't mention. Even better, if you want to head over to my Twitch channel, you can always ask me questions there live or share your comments there and we can talk about it in person. And just for posterity's sake, I'll go ahead and say it. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to my channel so you can keep seeing my guides and content coming out. So hopefully I'll see you in the comments below or over on Twitch or even in game. But until then, as always, stay safe out there.